Thank you for joining us. This is part C of section one of Orbic basic training, where we will discuss choosing an interface module. In addition, we will discuss the basics in terms of how Orbic runs, as well as the reading modes. So now, once you have chosen your Orbic sensors, the next thing you want to choose is the type of output that you want. And you have three basic options. You can output to a personal computer, you can output to a PLC, or you can output to a Solartron supplied readout. First, we're going to discuss outputting to a computer, which is the most common way Orbit is used. We have four basic options. The first is a USB interface module, the most common one. There's also a wireless Bluetooth, where if for whatever reason you cannot directly connect to the computer, you can output the readings over Bluetooth to the computer. Then you have RS-232. This is, of course, an older technology, but it's actually still very popular. And then you have Ethernet TCP IP, where you can output through an Ethernet cable or over an Ethernet network. Now, before choosing an interface module, let's discuss the basics about how Orbit works. You know, first things first, each Orbit module has a serial number. And if you have one, you can see the serial number on the backside of the Orbit module. Now, first thing that a computer or readout does that's connected to an Orbit stack is that it identifies all the modules on a network actually using that serial number using a ping or notify command. Then the computer or the readout sends a command for the reading and the module responds. Here's just a quick exercise for identifying probes using our Orbit GCS software, two digital probes, and the USB interface. First, we will go to the hardware page on the GCS software, and then connect to the USB interface module. So now when we click Find All Modules, if you'll note on the Orbit stack itself, you'll see the USB blink and the other two modules blink. And then the addresses in the software match the ID numbers on the modules themselves. So there you see them on display here. So another feature I want to discuss is one called hot swap. So with hot swap, what the feature is that inside every T connector is a chip that also records the address of the module every time a module is identified. So where this comes in handy is, let's say that this Orbit network is on a manufacturing line and a probe becomes damaged. What you can actually do is just pull that module and then replace it with another one of the same measurement range. Now, in certain cases, you might need to reset it or cycle the power, but what you don't have to do is go back in and re-identify the probe. So your downtime is very minimal. Now, here's just a quick hot swap example. We have one probe set up with the GCS software. Here we will remove it and then place another probe with the same measurement range on the TCON. And as you can see, it's operating normally. However, I should note that it might not be this smooth with certain software packages or systems. You might have to reboot the software. So the next thing we want to discuss, as this is a factor for choosing interface modules, is network speeds and read modes. First, we'll talk about network speeds. Orbit network operates at three different network speeds. Now, by default or standard, the Orbit network runs at about 187.5 kilobytes per second. But it also has a higher rate, which is 1.5 megabytes per second, or ultra high, which is 2.25 megabytes per second. I should note that for most standard applications, if you're doing just a simple gauging operation, the standard Orbit network speed will be more than fast enough for what you're doing. High or ultra high are much better for read burst modes if you need, or dynamic modes if you need it much quicker. Now, there are five types of read modes that Orbit offers. The first is just the most common, static or basic. And this is where, you know, the computer sends a command and the module send back a reading one at a time. So this is best for static measurements, like if you're doing a simple A plus B reading, or perhaps, you know, a couple of different shaft measurements. Now, that might sound slow with one reading at a time, but it's still very quick feedback. This will happen within just a few milliseconds. But then the next mode we have is dynamic. Now, this is high-speed synchronized readings, and this is up to 3,906 readings per module per second. And this is only available with the USB interface module and the new Ethernet interface module that we have just started to offer. Now, here's just a dynamic mode example showing the capability of the Orbit network. So let's say you have one USB interface module, and you have 16 probes checking a spinning shaft, like what you see there. Each particular module can output up to 3,906 readings per second. And then actually the USB can take in 16 of those. So actually the USB is taking in and exporting 62,496 readings per second. It should be noted though that dynamic mode for Orbit can actually function well beyond 16 modules. So for example, this is a chart showing the dynamic capabilities for the USB interface module. So at 31 modules, you can still operate at 1,000 readings per module per second. Or even at 150 modules, the USB interface module will still be capable of running 400 readings per module per second in dynamic mode. Then the next read mode is called read burst. And this is where it's kind of like dynamic mode, where you have one high-speed synchronized reading of all the modules on the network. So compared to static, where like perhaps it sends one reading at a time, here, if you send the read burst command, all of them come at once. So it's like one instantaneous dynamic measurement. What some of our customers have actually done, instead of trying to implement like a dynamic mode, is just to have a rapid read burst command sent to the Orbit network, which can almost replicate a dynamic mode if you're doing it at lower speeds. The next is buffered mode. Now, buffered mode is where actually the module can store up to 3,000 readings and then output them on command. We actually offered this when Orbit was first started back in 1995. Now, back at that time, computers were a little bit slower and they were not able to take in all the readings at once that Orbit could possibly output. So we offered this buffered mode as kind of an option. Now, of course, nowadays, any computer, especially a Windows 10 computer, has no problem taking in 64,000 readings a second or whatever Orbit can throw at it. However, we still offer this feature just in case. Then we also have what's called difference mode. This is where, believe it or not, the Orbit module can actually track the maximum and the minimum readings, and then those can be extracted on command. So this can be handy, especially for TIR readings, if you're doing any type of runout. Now, this is just a chart that breaks down the capabilities of all four interface modules. As you can see, the USB interface module and the Ethernet interface module 2.0 have all network speeds, including standard, high, and ultra high, as well as all reading modes, including dynamic, and they can have a max read rate per module of 3,906 readings per second. The IRS232 interface and the wireless interface have slower data transmission capabilities, so they are not available with dynamic mode, and as you can see, the maximum read rate per module is significantly lower. Now, to run Orbit with computers, first thing you do is download some free Orbit software drivers from the Solartron website. These software drivers are actually Windows 10 compatible with 32-bit or 64-bit systems. They should run on previous versions of Windows, but these drivers have been tested against Windows 10. Anyways, when you download these software drivers, what you get is the Orbit suite, like what you see right here. You also get manuals, programming examples, firmware updates, as well as several other features. So then, with the Orbit drivers, you have several different options. You can incorporate Orbit into any SBC package or other software package. Examples would be LabVIEW, QC Calc, or GageSoft, and others. So the software package that you see on the right-hand side there, that is actually one that was created with LabVIEW. Or you can also build your own software around it. This is something else we'll be discussing in training for Section 2. It should also be noted too, with Orbit, you have the options of The Solartron provided software, which is Orbit GCS, which stands for Gauge Computer Software. This is a downloadable software pack. The basic levels are free of charge, and then you have some upgrades for formulas, mastering, and SBC. You also have an option of a free Excel add-in pack. And this is where you can output data directly into Excel spreadsheets. There is training on both of these. You can also contact your local Solartron representative. So our next option for choosing an interface module is if you want to output the readings from Orbit into a PLC. And for that, we use what we call a protocol interface module, or PIM. What this is capable of doing is basically taking the readings from the Orbit stack and then outputting them into one of several protocols: Profinet, Ethernet IP, EtherCAT, Modbus, and we actually have two options for Modbus: Modbus TCP over IP, as well as Modbus over RS-485 serial. In addition, a PIM for CC-Link is going to be available sometime in 2021. So now, how the PIM basically functions: it acts as a translator from our Orbit protocol to a PLC protocol. This is something you actually set up with the free software pack, like what you see right here, where you identify the probes and then basically set up the PIM in relation to the configuration with the PLC. This is an example where it's talking to Ethernet IP. So again, this is something that will be discussed in the PIM training in section 3. So then our third option is actually choosing an Orbit readout. Now for this, you actually don't require an interface module. These are built to connect directly to an Orbit stack. Now Solartron does offer a wide variety of digital readouts. This includes the SI-1500, which is a simple single channel, the SI-3500, which is dual channel, and has some basic formulas such as A plus B, A minus B. Then there's the SI-5500, a 32 channel with formulas, and it can power both probes and lasers. Then you have Orbit ACS, which is basically a standalone Orbit system that you can use for very simple 1-to-4 channel operations. I'll have RS-232 output as well as IO. So now we're going to go to part D, where you can connect Orbit to third-party sensors. So after you have chosen your Solartron sensors as well as your interface module, one option you have is to use Orbit to connect to perhaps third-party sensors that your gauge or your system are going to use. So for example, Solartron Metrology does not build a rotary encoder, but we do have a module that can connect to a rotary encoder. Same thing for a thermocouple or other types of sensors. So Solartron actually offers a wide variety of configurable connection modules. We have an analog interface module, and this is something where you can connect to any sensor with a DC, 4020 milliamp, or PT100 output. So this is an application example where an analog interface module is connected to a thermocouple. Perhaps you might have to monitor temperature while you are gauging a ball bearing, for example. Then we also have the encoder interface module. And this will connect with any sensor with a TTL or a square wave output. And where this is most often used is to connect to, again, rotary encoders or other sensors of that type. This is an example where actually you can use Orbit, or you can use the encoder interface module, to trigger dynamic readings. So if you are doing some type of rotational shaft and want to take a reading every degree, every 5 degrees, that type of thing, this type of EIM encoder interface module can be used. Then we also have the digital input output module, which is actually on its second generation DIOM2. Now what this is used for is, let's say you are running Orbit with a computer, but you still want to be able to signal a PLC, or perhaps signal another sensor, or even a light tower, those sorts of things. You can actually use the digital input output module for those types of readings. In addition, if you want to perhaps use a foot switch to trigger a reading, This is where the DIOM2 would come in handy. There is actually a completely separate training video all on the DIOM. And we also have the strain gauge interface module. And this is built to connect with any full bridge or half bridge circuit. And that is typically the type of circuitry used for a load cell or a similar technology. And we also have the digimatic interface module. And this will connect with any sensor with a digimatic output. And actually, Mighty Toyo, for example, has this type of output available for sensors like what you see there. Also for Orbit, we have the air gauge module. Solartron Metrology does not build air gauge sensors, but we do manufacture the electronics for it. So now you can connect and calibrate any air gauge sensor into the Solartron Orbit network. Where this actually comes in handy is applications like this, where perhaps you are using contact probes, but you are also using air gauging and perhaps need one solid unit to bring it into a computer. Also, we have the wireless connection module. This is where you can connect any Solartron wireless device, such as the Wii gauge or the multi-channel Wii gauge, and bring the readings in through Orbit. We will have a separate training section on this as well. So here's an example of an Orbit stack with a wireless connection module. Two probes are checking the outer diameter, while the Wii gauge is checking the inner diameter. The readings are being fed through the WCM, and all readings are being sent into the computer at once. So that concludes parts C and D of the Orbit Basics training. For part E, which discusses the power supply interface modules, please click the I in the upper right-hand corner, or if you are watching this on a playlist on the Solartron YouTube channel, please sit tight, and it should begin shortly. Thank you.